Graniola. This is the Graniola channel, and I'd like to tell you a folk tale. This Middle Eastern story that deals with the subtleties of dispensing justice is called The Unintentional Huntress. A very long time ago, could have been 200 years ago, it might have been 300, there lived an old man in a little house all by himself. His children never came to visit him, even though they lived quite close by, and the only thing he really had to entertain him was a raven. That scruffy bird and he would sit down several times a day and literally break bread together. The raven with its beak and the frail octogenarian with his gums, because he had lost all of his teeth. The long-lived host would chat away and the raven would move his head back and forth to show that he was interested in the conversation. After each of these meals, they would take a walk together, the raven mostly resting on the old man's shoulder and every once in a while darting off to look at something that she thought was interesting. One afternoon when they saw a buffalo in the field that they were crossing, the raven flew off and landed on one of its horns. The elderly gentleman was delighted because he considered that the buffalo was now his because his raven had hunted it. He nudged the big beast in the direction of his little house, and soon the three of them were resting under the shade of a tree in front of it. As it happened, and this shouldn't be a surprise to anyone at all, that buffalo belonged to the old man's neighbor. Even though these two men did not live very far from each other, they very seldom spoke. In the opinion of the buffalo's owner, his next-door neighbor was a doddering, superannuated fool of little importance. And so, instead of going over and asking him politely to return the buffalo, he decided to get in touch with a judge. This resulted in the old man receiving a summons demanding that he appear in court. He succeeded in arriving at the town hall a few moments before his trial was to begin, and he offered the judge a big pot of ghee as a bribe. The tactic succeeded, and the buffalo was awarded to the flying huntress and her companion. When the judge got home, he opened the container of ghee and was disgusted to smell that it was totally rancid. He was furious and sent a policeman to bring the old man to him. When the old man arrived and realized how upset the judge was, he began to talk slyly. "Esteemed magistrate, everyone in the community is dumbfounded by the fact that you passed down a judgment in favor of a raven who's worth only one coin to the detriment of a huge, magnificent beast who's worth at least 1,000 coins. People are wondering on what law you based your decision." The judge, realizing that he had been foolish to accept a bribe, was silent. The old man returned to his home, and with the same stick that he had used to bring the buffalo to his house, now led him back home to his neighbor. And the old man and his raven continued their life as it had been before the incident, and happily lived for many more years. This is a tale that is told in Iraq. Even though the name of that country appears mostly today in connection with violence and war, culturally it's one of the richest places on earth and was nicknamed the cradle of civilization. An apt description for a place where thousands of years ago both robots and writing were invented.